So, yes, it's another year of being virtual, and it is according to the list that I got from Mark, the registration spreads 17 time zones. So, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, good late night, good early morning. And I assume that I covered everyone in the audience. So thank you for joining us for the 22nd Condor Week. And as we keep tally, it is year 37 of us doing this Condor stuff, and it's 15 years since we started CHTC, and more on that in later on. So in November 2020, the IEEE Technical Committee on Distributed Processing recognized the influential contribution of the Condor system to distributed and high throughput computing with the 2020 Outstanding Technical Achievement Award. So that was quite a recognition, and I encourage you to take a look at who else received this recognition, and I'm sure that it will make you all feel very good. Because in my comments when receiving the recognition, I pointed out that these contributions are a result of a community, and a broad community that does not only include the individuals that contributed to the software stack itself, but also to all of you out there who adopted a Condor over the years and provided us with invaluable feedback that got us to where we are. But I regret that I talked only about the researchers that adopted a Condor, and I failed to mention all the commercial organization that also adopted a Condor over the years and played an important role in our, what I hope, the lasting contribution to distributed computing and high throughput computing. And just 2 weeks ago, I got a reminder of one of these commercial adopters when Brian shared with us this article from Overflow about how SpaceX is testing their software. And I am sure that we all feel pleased to know that they're using HTCondor as their backend for their continuous integration. Yes, CI stands for continuous integration, not only for cyber infrastructure. And also they had some kind word to say about HTCondor in general. And for those of you who wonder what the HITL testbeds means, it is hardware in the loop testbed. And you can imagine that in SpaceX, there's a lot of software testing that involves other hardware than iPhones and laptops. So this obviously is rewarding, and we reached out to him, and I hope that down the road, they will also tell us about their experience in using HTCondor for continuous integration. But it also reminded us that we started in using HTCondor for continuous integration many years ago. And here's the paper that we published in 06 about the NMI build and test laboratory. There we not only used HTCondor or Condor at the time to serve as a backend, we also developed a whole service on this, hoping that we can get the community to adopt it. I would say that that was with limited success. And today, as most of you are aware, the community drifted to using services for continuous integration provided by some of the commercial entities. But it was also an opportunity to remember that at the same time, starting in 98, actually Oracle used HTCondor as the backend for their continuous integration system. And here's a report at the time, Optina in 2006 reported, and it was almost a decade that HTCondor was responsible for all the build and tests of the Oracle software. So that's a sort of a reminder of what we did in the past, and let's start looking a little bit more into the future. So in October last year, we started a partnership as a result of 5 years, $4.5 million annual budget NSF award. And the partnership that we call PATH, Partnership for Advanced Throughput Computing, is a promise, and that's the reason NSF funded us, to expand distributed high throughput computing technologies and methodologies through innovation, translational effort, and large-scale adoption to advance the science and engineering goals of the broader community. And it's important to note that what we have in this partnership is aligned with the NSF Cyber Infrastructure Blueprint. And here's a picture of this blueprint as presented by the director of the Office of Advanced Cyber Infrastructure at NSF, also late 2020. And you can see where PATH and OSG, and more about OSG shortly, fit into this bigger picture of where NSF views the national cyber infrastructure moving. And I will put here sort of a footnote that in the next couple of years, we expect to see significant changes in the cyber infrastructure landscape funded via NSF as XSEED reaches its end and is transitioning to what NSF is calling these days access. So the partnership, which is an organic one, is between the UW-Madison Center for High Throughput Computing and the OSG Consortium. And I'll spend a little bit of time now to share with some of you who are not familiar with these two organizations what they are. And it builds on decades of collaboration and a common vision, and what we find always critical in these lasting partnership, shared principles. The two main elements of PATH are the HTCondor software suite. We look at all the software that is coming out of the shop that Todd is leading as a software suite with all the components in it. And then there is a fabric of capacity services that we call Focus that is offered by the OSG. It involves about 40 individuals at 7 institutions, and the partnership is committed to community building. In other words, HTCondor Weeks will continue, and the OSG school will also continue. So for at least the next 5 years. So here's a little bit about the structure. So the leadership involved Brian Bockelman, Lauren, Michael Tottenbaum, and Frank Wolfswine. And I serve as the PI. And you can see here the four areas that are part of PASS and the connection to the OSG consortium, the CHTC, and all the external resources that are part of the national cyber infrastructure supported by the NSF. I would like to note here that the OSG Council serves as the advisory board for PASS, and all this is operated by a cooperative agreement with NSF. So there is a continuous communication between PASS and the NSF about what we did, where we are, and where we are heading. So CHTC was founded in 2006 with this, I would say, pretty unique vision of bringing high throughput computing to all fields of research and allowing the future of high throughput computing to be shaped by the insight from all fields of research. So CHTC is the home for the HTCondor software suite. It's also operating an HTCondor pool and a Slurm cluster that are open under fair share to any campus researcher and their collaborator. This is an important principle that we believe in, that computing capacity should be available to anyone who has an idea without going through a lot of red tape. We are supporting sharing across about 10 campus condor pools, including big ones like the CMS Tier 2, the Ice Cube Tier 1 or Tier 0, depending on how you count it. But we have things like biostatistics and space sciences and others on the campus. And we have pioneered and we are providing a campus researcher with research computing facilitation services that you will hear more about it later in this condo week. The OSG consortium was established a year earlier. It is governed by a council. This is important because it is not a project. It is a group of stakeholders that believe in the mission and are committed to follow it. And the consortium members include campuses, research collaboration, software providers, and compute, storage, and networking providers as well. The OSG provides a fabric of services to consortium member and to the broader US science and engineering community. And I will talk more about it in the following slide. While members of the consortium own and operate resources, at the moment, OSG does not own or operate any resources. The council elects the OSG executive director that today is Frank, which is a co-PI on PASS, and appoints an executive team that together they manage the effort that is available through the different projects to the OSG. So here's the OSG statement of purpose, and you see that it's pretty much aligned with PASS and with the CHTC, where it's advancing distributed high throughput computing by advancing the technologies and advancing the adoption. And here's sort of an overview of the fabric of services that are really today part of focus. And there is one of them is the community building. The other one is research computing facilitation. And then we have all the operation that brings all this together. As we always in high throughput computing, we operate to sustain scalability. A lot of recent effort, and you will hear more about it this week, about the whole question of trustworthiness and how do we establish trust and reproducibility by recording information. In terms of numbers of OSG, we claim that we deliver 2 billion core hours a year across 130 clusters located in more than 70 sites. And we are also managing today through the Storage Federation, 200 terabytes of data cached across 17 caches that are actually deployed worldwide. And here's a nice picture map of how this all looks together. So recently I was asked the question, how do cloud resources fit into the distributed high throughput computing model of the OSG? And my answer was naturally, because it's all about offering access points. And for those of you who are familiar with HTCondor lingual, then it is SCDs, and service to deploy execution points, i.e. in Condor language, studies. And let me bring this all into context, describing what we refer to as the open science pool. So one of the services that we provide by OSG are what we call access books that are open to any US researcher. So one message from this opening remark, if you know about somebody with US connection to a US institute who needs or wants to do high throughput computing, just go to OSG Connect and follow the instruction there. And these access points provide capacity through HTCondor pool that is managed under a fair share scheduling policy. I believe that over the years, we have been focusing too much about the resources that can come through a deployment of HTCondor and less about the services, the functionality and the power of what I call the access points. And we have to remember that the access points are the one that provides the workload automation, the auditing, the workflow management, like Dagman and Pegasus, that are designed to accommodate high throughput application. And yes, in a distributed environment. So there is a lot of what's happening at the access point. And the way that the open science pool works is a researcher brings the data, the input sandbox to the access point, or they can place it in the OSG Data Federation. And then the output sandbox is staged back to the access point. So I am running out of time, but I want to bring up something that I think is important to where we are heading forward, and that is in the past executive summary, in the broader impact, we talk that the past partnership are firmly believing in a paradigm which support democratization of research computing to include research and organization otherwise underrepresented in the national CI. And here's a slide from a talk that I gave 20 years ago at Boston University, where I pointed out that all the stuff we are doing under Condor at the time is about democratization of computing, basically saying you don't have to be a super person in order to benefit from supercomputing power. And this is a challenge that the NSF size AD, Margaret Montesoni, presented the community when we celebrated the 35 years to NSFNet. And the thing was democratizing access to federated resources. And we are working hard in making our access point a means for achieving this democratization. And I have more slides. Take a look at them later for some more details about how we plan on doing this. And I cannot end my talk without my favorite slide. And thanking you for building such a wonderful and thriving high throughput computing community.